The Prime Minister Narendra Modi has yesterday raised some questions about Kerala agriculture and as to why there are no APMC markets and why farmers in Kerala are not protesting for more APMC markets, while the All India Kisan Sabha is protesting across the country against the three anti-farmer bills. The Prime Minister clearly is ignorant about the agriculture of Kerala. The agriculture sector in Kerala largely consists of plantation crops and known more as commercial crops. And these crops have historically had commodity boards like rubber board, coffee board, tea board, spices board, coconut development board, and so on. And these have entirely been under the central government. In the last 30 years, repeatedly, the different governments led by BJP and Congress have been diluting these commodity boards, defunding these commodity boards, and that has led to increased distress in the state. However, there is an auctioning mechanism. The state government there has been intervening in favor of the farmers, and even when there are price crashes internationally, the state governments have come in support of the farmers. As far as other crops are concerned, like paddy, the state government procures paddy paying around 900 rupees more than the central government's minimum support price. While the central minimum support price is 1868 per quintal, Kerala procures paddy at 2768. So that is the kind of intervention that the Kerala government has been making. 16 vegetables, the base prices have been announced by this Kerala government. And Kerala government also provides a royalty of 2,000 rupees per hectare to rice cultivators. So it is these kind of interventions that have been made. Different cooperatives are intervening. Huge subsidies by the state governments and local self-governing institutions are given to farmers in the state. While the Prime Minister is seeking to mislead the people of our country about the role played by the LDF government in the state, we would like to urge upon the government to strengthen the commodity boards, and also to withdraw from unequal free trade agreements, which have led to price crashes for farmers in Kerala and elsewhere. The last effort by the BJP government and Prime Minister is clearly in the wake of massive response to the call of different organizations of the farmers against the three anti-farmer bills. And they are clearly rattled by the united struggle that has been going on in our country.